And how come you, do you still recall the first time you thought about this line, I have to use this line?
Yeah, I do, because I was reading on the road, and I read it when I was 16. I didn't enjoy it because I didn't understand it. I didn't have enough experience in life to enjoy or understand it. So I read it again when we were touring on our last record. And I remember we were at Galen, our bass player's mother's house in Milwaukee. And I went down and I got a haircut. And I went to this restaurant and I was drinking a Bloody Mary at the bar.
I remember this moment.
And I was reading it. And I saw the sentence and I folded the page over. And as soon as I got my hand on a pen, I like underlined it and wrote it down in a notebook. And I said, God, that's just such a dense sentence. I can get a whole record out of it, I'm pretty sure.
And what was your feeling then?
I thought it was funny in a weird way. I mean, the setup of the sentence, boys and girls in America have such a sad time together. He'd just been on a bus and he met this really pretty girl from a farm. And after talking to her for about 20, 30 seconds, he tried to make out with her. And she didn't want any part of it. And his reaction, you know, boys and girls in America have such a sad time together. I just thought it was so funny. And it was a very sort of true statement about how men and women interact at times, especially as young men and women. So I don't know, I thought it was funny, but also just sort of very true and sort of beautiful, beautifully said.
Okay, so that's why, well, because you were saying, well, it all comes down to the same theme, but can you be a bit more precise?
Well, it's just sort of the theme about boys and girls and love and relationships and thinking about, you know, that some love is something that people don't understand any better at my age, 35, than they do when they're 17. And it's also very, you know, I think you're always searching for a universal topic when you're a songwriter. You want something that everyone can understand, whether they're from Minnesota or Amsterdam or Japan, you know. So I felt like it was, there's obviously been a million love songs written. And there's a reason for that. It's because, you know, it's a part of everyone's life.
But did you learn from writing the songs?
Oh, yeah, you always learn something. I mean,
what is an even one thing that you've learned?
Well, what have I learned? I mean, I think that one thing I learned is that without the lows that love and, you know, relationships and lack of love bring. Without that, there could never be the highs that love can also bring, and that, you know, those things are part of what makes life, you know, and being stranded eternally in the middle would actually be a worse thing than experiencing those lows.
And are you in a relationship right now? Or?
Mm-hmm.
And it's. It's high now.
Yeah, it's high now.
It's high.